Bitch, you always, on my line, you ain't never got a diamond, get a liquor store, the D-boy in designer, the glory. Then you hit my line and all I ever get is the story. But you know that, I'm some pimpin'. I'm no pimpin', say yo, dig me, say you dig me. But you ain't tryna hoe, So institute, my institute is totally different. Bitch, you totally a bum and I'm just totally pimpin'. Gave a couple niggas money, I need my moment though. You gave a lot of niggas honey, bitch, I need some hoeing though. You need to give a pimp the money, give me my moment, ho. Charge them suckers for the honey, I just need some hoeing. You weak bitches, y'all so broken, y'all just broken. You don't ever hoe, hoe up on the track all day, but whack all day is truly no mashing. You ain't trying to run the checkup, you just do it for fashion. Man, I love it, when a bitch is a hoe, bitch, she don't ever choose the clout or she ain't trusting no disgusting tricks, she trap with position. You won't catch it with no boyfriend, she attracted to you gave a couple niggas money, I need my moment though. You gave a lot of niggas honey, bitch, I need some hoeing though. You need to give a pimp the money, give me my moment, ho. Charge them suckers for the honey, I just need some hoeing though. You don't wanna be taken for it, fuck off, stay the fuck off. Up hip line, we up bro line, we I got hoes that pay me for my time, so how do I look? If you ain't paying pimpin', bitch, pay attention, bitch, pay attention to the hook. You gave a couple niggas money, I need my moment though. You gave a lot of niggas honey, bitch, I need some hoeing though. You need to give a pimp the money, give me my moment, ho. Charge them suckers for the honey, I just need some hoeing though. You gave a couple niggas money, I need my moment though. You gave a lot of niggas honey, bitch, I need some hoeing though. You need to give a pimp the money, give me my moment, ho. Charge them suckers for the honey, I just need some hoeing though. Greater or lesser, that pressure gon' test her and see. And if it's destined, then that's gon' bring out the best of her. See? You see?
Don't worry, man. You know what I mean? I got time tonight. You know what I mean? Sin gonna sit up there, man. You know what I mean? And really bless y'all tonight. You know what I mean? So as far as the Quando Rondo video, we gonna have to run that back again. I got a new phone. I accidentally sat up there and deleted the damn video. So that's deleted. So we gonna have to run that back again. And we gonna run it back again. So it is what it is. I got videos to do tonight. And we gonna run through them. Don't even, you know, I got you. I got you, man. You know what I mean? Seeing you deleted the game. Yeah, bro, I did it, bro. This is what it is, bro. No, that wasn't YouTube fault. No, seeing said, listen, once I hit end, right? This is exactly what happened, bro. I hit the end button. The video goes off. You know what I mean? The bitch sit up there, you understand me, and called me. You know, she wasn't talking about nothing. Okay, so bam, I get off the phone with her big head ass. Did she say, I couldn't understand why it told me that. It's like, do you want to resume the video or do you want to end it? And I'm in my mind like, shit, I had already ended it. So I hit the end button and this shit just deleted the whole video. So I got to run that shit back again, man. We got to run that again. So we gonna be up tonight. You know what I mean? We're going to be up tonight. But in the meanwhile, man, hit that like button. I got videos that I'm getting ready to drop tonight. You know what I mean? So we're going to run through. I'm not going to be able to really do my thing too much on this one because I got so much videos that I got to give tonight. So, man, hit that like button right now. Get the likes up. Let's hurry up and get over 100. I'm going to drop another song. And after I finish the song, y'all should have them likes over 100. Let's go.
dedicate this one to all the fellas who got a hard head bitch who just won't listen. You know, the best thing to do is to leave her. Don't hit her. Shake that hoe real quick.
Bitch, I'm gone. Hey. Bitch, I'm gone. I can't take it no more. I can't get through to you. There's nothing I can say that you seem to understand.
Bitch, I'm gone.
I'm out.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I'm through with you.
Oh, I'm through with you. Knew that you was a hoe back then, and bitch, you're still one now. You like to bust nuts in your face, but with that big ass smile. You need to shut the fuck up, you talk too much. I told you once before, yeah, that pimpin' don't. I could tell you twice, so I'm walking out that door. Oh yeah, bitch, I got to get the hell out of here. I can't get through to you. You talk too much. I can't tell you shit.
Bitch, I'm gone.
Oh yeah, I'm gone. I'm back to get through.
I'm through with you.
Oh yeah, I'm through with you, bitch. Hey, yeah.
Bitch, I'm gone. Bitch, I'm through with you. I'm through with you.
Cause I refuse to lose.
I can't be locked in your world. Bitch, I'm gone. I need to breathe. I got to roll.
With you.
Ain't no way
I can stay another day with you. Bye bye, bitch.
And with all the other pussy, yeah. A nigga got besides your big head, cutting butt for only kids, still living with your grandmama, fucking my ass. You should have known you was fucking with a Mac.
Mac.
Yeah. Instead of stepping your game up, you got pushed way to the back. I seen your expression when you see me pimping in the club. It looked like you wanted to break down and cry. But I just didn't give a damn. I didn't give a damn. No, I didn't. Cause bitches ain't shit anyway. So don't ask me why. I'm gone. Yes, I am. I got to get the hell out of here. Oh yeah,
bitch, I'm gone.
Oh bitch, I got too many bitches anyway.
I'm through with you.
To be fooling with your ugly ass. Oh, break it down. Oh,
break it down.
Oh, we got to break it down.
Break it down. Oh, break it down.
Oh, oh yeah. Seeing you today, baby. You know what? Sit the fuck down, bitch. Playing no goddamn game with you right now, bitch. You know what I mean? It's a lot of time and effort up in this shit. You know what I mean? I want to tell you a little something like this, bitch. I got everything. You don't have nothing. Bitch, I ain't believing a motherfucking word you say, bitch. Get your shit. Get the fuck out of here. Even though it's your motherfucking house, the fuck up out of here. You know what? I'm leaving this motherfucker. Got a 4-bedroom upstairs. I'm moving your sister in, bitch. I gotta protect the water and get your punk bitch ass. So we gonna be partying all night long, bitch. And your sister and twin, so
bitch,
I'm gone.
Bitch, I'm gone. My car's parked right outside. I got a full tank of gas. And away I go.
How could you ask me, is that a Sinful The P track? And you hearing Snoop Dogg's voice. Come on, man. That song right there is an old classic. You supposed to been on that. You know what I mean? Like, where y'all be at? Hold on, let me do this right quick. There we go. All right, cool. You know what I mean? Man, I appreciate you guys for being here. You know what I mean? Because you could be anywhere else, but the game got your big head ass right up in here listening to this game. So blessings to everybody, man. I hope you're doing good. Hope you're enjoying your weekend. You know what I mean? For this quick little game session. You know what I mean? I hope you get every blessing, man, that the game wants you to have. Blessings to everybody. But getting right to it, because I ain't got time. I'm running through videos tonight. you're gonna see exactly what I mean. You know, when we look at the game, you know, let's just be 100. You know, hold on. I don't know why I keep doing that. The comments don't. But anyway, when we look at the game today, you know, of course, you know, you got your handsome bitches and seeing like to say all the time. But you do have some very, very extremely marketable, attractive, beautiful bitches that's professing the horn on today. You really do. You know, there's some very, like, God has blessed these women to be some fine specimens. You know, I mean, gorgeous, you know, beyond beautiful. You know what I mean? Top model type. I mean, like, man, bitch is just gorgeous. You know what I mean? Fine as a motherfucker. If we just judged her by appearance, man, it's just extremely attractive. Hold on, I'm gonna make sure my connection is. You know, there's a lot of attractive women that's professing the hoeing today. You know, now I make my jokes. You know what I mean? I talk about all the bitches that, you know, look like Stacey Augman, that look like Otis Thorpe. You know, CM might say that a bitch look like Sean Elliott. Some of you bitches do look like Sam Cassell in his rookie year. You know, but beyond the Xavier McDaniel, Stacey King, you know what I mean, Cliff Levinston looking bitches out there, it really is still some attractive, marketable, beautiful bitches out here. You know what I mean? Very beautiful. But as far as the problem is, what I'm seeing, you know, and not just before I even get into what I'm about to get into with them, you know, because, you know, like I said, it's just some very beautiful bitches. But I'm not taking away from, you know, they look and everything. But the reason why a lot of them, you know, feel the way that they do is because of you niggas. Yeah, I know you was going to laugh at that. I know y'all was looking, you know, those that know basketball, you know, if you, you know, if you're a woman or you're a guy that, you know, pretty, you're pretty much a bitch in a man's body, you probably wouldn't know the people that I just named. But those that know, they know. But, you know, in this social media world, this era of clout, you know, you have bitches that feel exalted. And it's pretty much because of the plethora, the fucking scrolls that you niggas is putting in DMs and comment sections and, you know, text messages and shit like that, that's really got them. First of all, the bitch look in the mirror, you know what I mean? She can see that she's attractive. But when you got an innumerable amount of, you know, thank you for accepting my friend request ass niggas, you know, sitting over there giving God praise each and every day, thanking his maker, you know what I mean, that this big head bitch, you know, even acknowledged him or accepted his friend request or accepted his follow after he been requesting the bitch for 4 months and all of that shit. I understand why you have a lot of bums that think highly of themselves. You know, a lot of these bitches can't sit up there and spell. You know what I mean? The bitch spells on a third grade level. You know what I mean? Bitch don't even know how to write in cursive. I'm talking facts. I didn't come out, you know, to start no drama and things like that. But a lot of these bitches, not just in the game, but just, you know, on social media, a lot of these square prostitutes that y'all calling IG models and shit, these bitches is stupid. A lot of you niggas have never having no pimping with you, and your campaign is despicable. You know what I mean? And by every bitch, damn near every bitch that you done had in the game, you know, look like Muggsy Bowles and shit. You know what I mean? Mike Singletary built. You know, by the time that you sit up there and knock something that's attractive and beautiful, you willing to make deals or do whatever you got to do to maintain the bitch. All because, you know what I mean, all the ugly Larry Johnson, you know, grandma mom bitches that you had, you know, before you knocked a beautiful one, you know, and it's sad. Not calling no name. I know a lot of y'all gonna sit up there, you understand me, and feel that I'm talking about you, but I'm not talking about you. It's, you know, I'm not. It's not, P, you talking about? No, I'm not talking about you, but I am talking about you. I'm not talking about you, but I am talking about you. Not you, just you, but every nigga in your category, you know. I'm not picking on my little brothers, but if you in the category of the shoe fit, then, you know, as one prophet told one man, thou art the man. But yeah, man, let me just come straight in the dough, you know, with this game. You know, a lot of you niggas feel that you got lucky. You know, you really know in your heart, you really know in your mind that you really not the pimping like that. Okay? So you feel like you got lucky. You feel blessed. You know what I mean? That you got this big head bitch. You don't know what to do. You know? And so now that we're in the month of November, making our way to the month of December, you know, the bitch pretty much dictating, you know, your program. The bitch telling you how shit gonna go. The bitch telling you, no, I don't want to go outside. It's cold. All right, well, you know, well, maybe we could go. No, I don't want to go there. I'm not feeling that. Okay, well, what do you feel comfortable with? I don't know. I'm tired. And y'all laughing, but this is going on right now. Some of you niggas be in my comment section laughing and saying the most pimping shit, you know what I mean? But behind closed doors, you know what I mean? It's no pimping. It's no pimping, man. The bitch dictating everything. The bitch governing. She running the whole motherfucking house, man. Niggas getting in the comment section saying the most pimpish, sugar-free Mac Dre pimp C thing that they can find. You understand me? And ain't an ounce of shit that they heard another pimp say, you know what I mean? But you doing everything and everything behind closed doors to maintain that beautiful trash that you got. That bitch, from her physical appearance, she's beautiful, but she's trash. Some of y'all know exactly what the fuck I'm talking about. Niggas is looking at that bitch and they'll swear up and down from looking at the bitch that you got a fucking Ferrari, that you living in a mansion home, that you got hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of jewelry. They think you got properties owned, looking at the way this bitch look, and you ain't got shit. The bitch don't make shit. See, when you got especially a square or a nigga that's green as hell, you know, you think just because, you know what I mean, she's physically beautiful and everything like that, you know what I mean, that, man, this nigga must be living life. You know what I mean? He doing his thing, man. You know, no, he's not. He's not. He got beautiful trash. He doesn't have a hoe. She's not a hoe. She's just beautiful trash. You know, she's just beautiful trash. That's all she is. She don't want to go to the blade. She don't want to sit up there, you understand me, and get in the trick's face. You know, she just want to work when she want to work on the internet. You know what I mean? Then she barely generating any money on the internet. Beautiful trash. The bitch is trash. Nothing to talk about. Nothing to talk about. Some of y'all, you know what I mean? When you put them pictures and videos up, people look on Instagram and they'll swear up and down, oh my God, man, they look nice together. Or, damn, you know, his bitches look cute and everything like that. But what they can't see is you got two and three bitches and you making one bitch trap. Beautiful trash. You don't have hoes. You have beautiful trash. Attractive, thick, marketable, all of these things physically. But man, it just ain't adding up at all. You counting heads, but you're not counting bread. They got markability, but you're not seeing no currency. Got the beauty, you understand me, but you're not able to pay your utilities on time. Beautiful trash. When you sit up there, you understand me, and drive and going, beautiful trash. Not too long ago, one of my young peas, he gonna tell me, you know, bless his heart, he probably listening right now, you know, love, bro, you know, but he gonna sit up there and tell me, you know, man, the bitch gonna tell me, man, you know, She gonna continue to, Lord, I gotta hold my laugh together. The bitch gonna tell me, P, you know, she gonna continue to stay down and she gonna work for me and she gonna do what she do. But because she got a rap career, cause she promised some of her homeboys this Crips, when this video shoot, she can't hoe on this day because she got to sit up there and be at the video with the Crip homies and do this video. Beautiful trash. Trash. Beautiful trash. Yes, she looks good. You know what I mean? She look cool, but she's beautiful trash. Yay, Von, I got your Cash App, bro. Good looking, man. I appreciate that. You know, what does green mean? It means you're ignorant. When anybody says that you're green, that means that you're ignorant of something. Meaning that you're not knowledgeable. So if we say, yeah, man, he was green at the time, meaning he's a novice or he's ignorant or he's not knowledgeable. He doesn't, in other words, in simplicity, he doesn't know. He's green. He's new. But the bitch told him, she's like, I got a rap video coming up with the homies. She got some Crip homies that she about to send. Because the bitch thinks she going to be a rapper. You know what I mean? And she be watching my videos and shit too. You know what I mean? I want this game to hit you in the chest. If I lose, hey, listen. If I lose some loved ones, if I lose some so-called friends, you know what I mean? For sitting over there preaching the irrefutable truth of this game, so motherfucking be it. You know, I ain't talking about little bro, because that's my little bro. You know, but his little bitch, this bitch, she be listening to my videos from time to time. If she get offended, it is what it motherfucking is. But, you know, bitch got a nice body on her. You know, face, you know, sin ain't no liar. Her face is, she's striving. Amen. Touch somebody and say her face is striving. She got one of them striving faces. She's striving. Amen. She's trying to be on her way. But, you know, she got a cool little body. But the bitch thinks she's going to be the next Stunna Girl. Yeah, the bitch thinks she's going to be the next rapper. You know what I mean? The bitch think that, you understand me, she's getting ready to be the next, what's that guy name? Damn. That nigga just dropped a song, a diss song against Tory Lanez. Megan Thee Stallion. Tell the bitch nothing. You know, dude, just know that, you know, she's gonna make it. She just, you know. Now, I've heard her music. And y'all know how judgmental I am concerning music. That's why, because of the type of atmosphere that I've created on this platform, when I put my cousin up, I said, hey, man, don't spare him because that nigga my cousin. You know how we is over here. We tell the truth. You understand me? And when it's time to tell a motherfucker that they got it, we gonna tell a motherfucker they got it. But when a motherfucker need to get that CDL, we gonna tell a motherfucker he need to get that CDL. We gonna keep it real over here. But so the bitch, you know what I mean, she got her head all in the clouds and actually told my young P partner that she gonna sit up there, you understand me, and she ain't gonna be able to hold this day. Cause she got to get back on the bus or the plane so she can make it to this Crip video so she can dance and pop her ass in a goddamn Crip video with some Vegas Crips. So that's the reason why she can't do no Cali hoeing. She can't walk up and down the blades and shit because she got to sit up there and jump on the plane or the bus so she can sit up there and shake her ass in one of the Crip videos. Trash. Trash. I just got to keep it real. Trash. Goldie, what happened? Trash. Beautiful trash. Hit the like button. My like should look like my viewers. If I got 308 viewers, why don't I have 308 likes? Hit that like button right now. Hit the share button right now. If you're not subscribed to the channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Trash. The bitch is trash. Complete trash. It reminds me of a time, and some of y'all been watching my videos long enough to know exactly what the fuck I'm talking about. How many remember that video of me and Freeze throwing eggs at a bitch? Hey, amen. lean over to your neighbor and say, do you remember? Do you remember me and Freeze sitting over there throwing old ass eggs at this bitch? Who remembers? Okay, Goldie says he remembers. Okay, so let me give the backstory because I don't want no women coming up here. Oh my God, I thought this sin was a gentleman. Oh my God. Oh wow, he throwing eggs at bitches. Oh my, we gotta fight for black women. Oh my God, the most unprotected, the most unguided, the most non-getting dictated, the most being killed, the most disrespected person on earth is a black woman. Oh, this nigga throwing eggs. But anyway, so, you know, to give you the backstory on why the bitch had to get rebuked, you know, with these motherfucking eggs, is because I had another hoe, you know, at the time that actually, you know, favored, well, I ain't gonna get into that. I'll save that for another time, but actually favored a rapper, all right? And that's why I was trying to sit up there and knock this rapper, you know, because they both pretty much look like twins, real talk. And, you know, the rapper girl didn't know that, you know, I used to sit up there, you understand me? Well, I go get into it. I'll say that for another time. But the pretty bitch, the little bitch that I had, this other, the older bitch, she basically, you understand me, was jealous. I had an older bitch that was like 28. My young bitch at the time is like 20 going on 21. You know what I mean? I got other hoes out of town, but they the only two that I had in town. So at the time, you know what I'm saying, I'm playing that Phoenix and everything like that, you know, and Sin gonna keep it all the way 100. You know, Sin ain't gonna sit up there and sugarcoat shit. At the time, I had not touched the older bitch, you know, and she wasn't old. I'm just saying she's older. But at that time, I had not physically done anything with that bitch. And to keep it 100, you know, it wasn't that she was ugly. You know, it's just that I wasn't feeling her spirit. You know, the bitch used to do things like, I remember one time I had to sit up there and really rebuke the devourer one night because the bitch sat up there, you understand me, and got intoxicated. The bitch, you understand me, was drinking demons and shit. You know what I mean? All on the blade and shit like that. So, you know, I had to sit up there and rebuke the devourer and preside over rebuking service. You know, and looking at this bitch, she had a body on her. Bitch had a nice ass. Bitch had titties. Face was, you know, her face wasn't all that. But but you know, she had a decent little body. She had a decent little body with her clothes off. You would never know it with her clothes on at the time. She's one of the motherfuckers. You know, you ever had a bitch when she take off her clothes and she like, damn, bitch, you got ass like that? God damn, where you just be hiding that shit? But anyway, she, you know, then pissed me off a few times. So I'm the type, you know, a bitch could have been cute. She could have been attractive in the beginning. But as she keep deviating and backsliding and subsiding and shit like that, you know, my dick, I'm not going to lose no blood from my heart to make my dick go up for this bitch. Oh, no, we won't be losing any blood. No blood will be used, bitch. No. No, mm-mm. So, you know, make a long story short, she was jealous of the little young bitch that I had knocked. She was originally from South Carolina. Now, I ain't gonna lie to you, you know what I mean? At the time, you know, I'm really having a cool little time with the little young bitch. I ain't gonna lie, you know, she sitting over there bringing it in. You know, because, you know, when you knock a new, fresh, young thing, you know, them young bitches be having that fire. You know, you be wanting to, you know, did you want to eat or anything like that? No, I mean, I want to sit up there and take it in because I'm a little tired, but I've only made 1,060 in my room, you know what I mean, is 140. So I can't go in because I got to sit up there and check, you know what I mean, another 140 just so I could pay for the room, just so I could keep your trap, you know, over 1,000. You know what I mean? I like that. I like when you sit up there and tell a young bitch, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, bitch, we about to sit up there, you understand me? And I know you tired and everything, but we need to go to the gym and things like, okay, I'm with it. Oh, yeah, yeah, we definitely can go. You know, I need to work on my calves. And I like that. I just like that young energy. You know what I mean? We having fun, we laughing, you know, because anybody know me, I'm stupid, you know what I mean? So, you know, I like a bitch with a personality. We got personality together, you know what I mean, and everything. Good chemistry. And I even had a little something with the older one, but she was jealous of the chemistry that I had with this bitch that was more attractive than her and more younger than her, more agile than her, you know what I mean, and more on fire with the game than her. And then I have to throw that in there too, because we gonna say things in totality. We're not gonna give scenes of the movie. We gotta give it in its entirety. But yeah, you know, Sin was sitting over there, you know, little legs was up in the air. Yeah, them little legs was in the air, you know, and I can't even lie to you. You know what I mean? Baby girl has some cold head on her. Yeah, baby girl has some cold head on her. And, you know, she was a nice little thing. You know what I mean? Nice little succulent titties. You know what I mean? Ass, you know, nice little ass on her. Nice little cheerleader cut up legs and shit. You know what I mean? So I ain't gonna lie to you. You know, I got my funds and I was having fun with that bitch. You know what I mean? I'm not like you niggas. You know what I mean? I be fucking hoes. I be having a good time. So, yeah, man, you know, the other bitch, she's jealous because, you know, I haven't touched her. You know, I'm flirting with her and everything like that. But I told you guys about that. You know, sooner or later, a bitch gonna want you to sit up there, you understand me, and enter into her garden. You know what I'm talking about? The bitch, you know, you've been giving all of these compliments, but the bitch been hoping that it brings some development of some fornication. She liked the communication, but she's waiting on that fornication. And her anticipation, you know what I mean, is growing, you know, higher and higher. So, you know, it comes a time, you know, when the compliments is cool, but a bitch wants you to draw down on her. You know what I mean? She wants you to sit up there and, you know, mark your territory and, you know, really sit up there and do your thing with her. Uh-huh. But I wasn't feeling that. So because of this bitch having jealousy of this bitch, she sits up there and pulls, well, prior to that, okay, let me rewind it back a little bit. The bitch was coming in with 330. 360. Now, anybody that know me, it's not about the numbers. It's about the effort. Okay. And now you've been with me a long enough time. You've been with me for some months now, you know, and, you know, you haven't evolved. Yeah. And it's not that your mental capacity is not up to par. It's just that you're so consumed in what I'm doing with this bitch, what I'm doing with my dick, with these other bitches, you know, that you can't focus on doing some hoeing outside, you know. And so now you're doing stupid shit. You know, you're going to the Jack in the Box and you're sitting over there talking to renegades and shit when Trix is, you know, driving and looking past you. You know, you're looking attractive, but you're just beautiful trash. And what you don't know is I'm on the blade and I see the traffic. Yeah, I see the cars passing by. But you're not even knowing that I'm looking at your dumb ass, you know what I mean, smoking a cigarette. Yeah, which is, you know, Sin don't tolerate that. You know, you smoke a cigarette, you know, you smoke that off work. But all of this, you know, walking, you know, smoking and all of that shit, walking on the blade, bitches having headphones and all of this type of shit, listening to Summer Walker and all of that, Sin don't play that. So the bitch basically, you understand me, she's just, you know, she done just became just a person that just didn't want to produce. You know, when somebody keeps coming in with 330, 380, you know, 260 continuously, you know, now, you know, and I can't lie about that. You know, Sin got to put that in there too. You know, when bitches start doing that, you won't be around me. Yeah, if it's been months, no type of, because I keep telling you, it's not about numbers. It's about a bitch using her ability to the best of her ability, you know what I mean, to get your motherfucking currency. You know what I mean? I could take a bitch that you would probably classify as ugly, or a bitch that you could classify as fat, and if them bitches sit up there, you understand me, and gave it they all each and every day, we'll see some production. But if you don't have any type of elevation, and I'm giving this information that's working with everybody else, I'm giving this information, you know what I mean, not only to your other wife, your wifeys, but I'm giving this information to young peas, and it's working out with the young pimps in their situation. So I know the information. It's not the information. It's not the game. Bitch, it's you. So, yeah, separation, man. You know, how can two walk together except they be agreed? I'm not in agreement with a broke bitch. I'm not in agreement with attractive trash. You know, Sin is not on one accord with beautiful trash at all. You know, so basically, you know, the bitch had to go. She had to be from around me. So because she's not around me no more, and she's jealous of this younger bitch that I'm still maintaining, she's seeing the younger bitch, you know what I mean, come out looking good. You know what I mean? She's seeing the bitch, you know what I mean, fresh attire, hair done, nails done, feet done. Every time she see this bitch, you done pulled out a knife. She done pulled out a knife. And she's sitting over there chasing the bitch on the blade. So when you seen me and Freeze throwing eggs at that bitch, that was because she had sat up there and pulled a knife out on my hoe. Yeah, that's the truth. That's why. You know what I mean? The bitch had sat up there and was chasing my young bitch on the blade with a fucking knife. So rather than me put my hands on her, you know what I mean? And all that, when I sat up there, you understand me, and caught the bitch. Hey man, I can't even lie to you. Me and Freeze sit up there, you understand me, and got up on that bitch just like boys in the hood and shit. You know what I mean? There she go, be in the corner. It was just like that. We took some old funky ass eggs, you know what I mean? And egged the shit out that bitch. You know what I mean? Egg the shit out there. I might even put that shit in my story. You know what I mean? Egg the shit out that bitch. And I caught her a good time in her motherfucking face. If you remember the video, she's like, oh my God, my motherfucking face. You know what I mean? Look at the footage. You know what I mean? The bitch sat up there and get hit in her face. She's like, oh my God, my face. So, you know, a bitch had to sit up there and learn. So, of course, when Square seen it, they just thought I was evil. Hit that like button, man. Come on, man. It's 412 people watching right now, and it's only 267 likes. Man, get them likes up, man. We need more women up in here. Come on, guys. Talking to the men up in here. Hit that like button, man. Let's get some more women up in here. Let's get the notifications out there. Some more people will be notified, you know, that this game is being glorified and magnified right now, you know? Yeah, so getting back, you know, on this. Well, first of all, baby, we got to, you talking about on my good side, I don't think that you would ever chase another broad down the street with a knife, you know what I mean, just because I'm not answering the phone, because I didn't add that in, but that's the truth. I wasn't answering the phone for the bitch either. You know what I mean? No, I'm not on one accord with beautiful trash. No. You know what I mean? And she wasn't even my definition of beautiful trash. She was really just trash. You know, but I had to sit up there and just let that be known, man. Whether unattractive trash, attractive, because if you don't value your pimping, who else gonna value it? If you don't see your pimping, hey Coco, if you don't see your pimping as top of the top, you know, beyond, you know what I mean, beyond, then, you know, how the hoes gonna see your pimping to be that? You don't even see yourself as that. So you have to see yourself like, you gotta see, you can't be sitting up there allowing no bitch to come at you like that. Yeah, baby, 430-84. But I don't sit up there, you understand me, and tolerate, you know, terrible performances. Especially when a bitch sitting over there, she not even giving it her all. Like I told you, it's not about 500, 1,000, 2,000, 3,000. Hey, check it out. What did I tell you? If a bitch sit up there and bring you 3,000, right? And if you ask her, was this your best? And if she honestly tell you no, then you know you so you didn't put in all your effort to even get this. And if she honestly tell you no, sincerely tell you no, then the same lecture that you give a bitch, you know what I mean, for $300-$500, that's the same way I'm going on that bitch that's gave this little $3,000. Because you didn't use all your ability to the best of your ability to get it. It's about using all of you to go get all of it. So whether it's $3,000, $5,000, $10,000, $500, $800, it's not so much about the number. It was about the amount of effort that you put in to get mine. Because we got sense enough to know that if a bitch sitting over there giving it her all, then you understand me, all of it is coming soon. So when a bitch first start and her numbers is not up to par, you know what I mean? All you got to do is sit up there and keep giving that bitch some encouragement so she can keep going to that pavement, man. Yeah. You don't say nothing discouraging to that woman. If you got a fresh, what I tell you guys, when you get a fresh turnout, you get a fresh turnout broad, you know, for those of you didn't hear that game the last time, when we get a fresh turnout broad, man, or at least with me, you know, I'm concerned about that bitch busting that cherry. I'm so concerned about that bitch catching her first date. Some of y'all, you know what I mean, you be putting, yeah, man, I told the bitch, you know what I mean, you know, go ahead and don't do nothing under a rack. I mean, that's cool that you got high expectations. That's what's up. You know what I mean? I can't knock that. That's what's up. It wasn't that the bitch wasn't endeavoring to get your money, but you had put the price so high up in the sky, and then her attire didn't even look like her attire didn't even look like nothing. But you got the bitch, you know, giving expensive prices, but the bitch don't look exclusive. She don't look expensive. You know what I mean? So that's why you didn't check no money. I like the fact that you at least gonna send a bitch out there to ask for it, you know, but at the same time, you got the bitch reaching up in the motherfucking heavens and all that type of shit, but she just got in the game. I'm not concerned about whether or not she did. No. I'm concerned about her busting her cherry. For those of you, you know, I know every nigga have it, but what did you do when you first took a woman's virginity? When you taking a woman's virginity, you don't sit up there, you understand me? Well, I can't say some of y'all niggas, you know, you gonna get down how you get down. But no, I don't get down like that. You're gonna be gentle. You're gonna be a gentleman. It's not about me, you know, busting a nut. It's not about me coming. You know, it's about, you understand me, being a gentleman at this time. You know, because I'm concerned about busting that cherry. You know, I'm not concerned about sitting over there fucking jackrabbiting her. And no, I'm not gonna jackrabbit the bitch. Not at all. I'm going to take my time and I'm going to be gentle. You know what I mean? Because you never get a second opportunity to repeat a first impression. And because I want progression, sexual progression with the bitch, I'm not going to sit up there, you understand me, and just ram my shit all in. No, that ain't how you do things. So that's the same way, you know, and the same way after, you know, just like when a bitch sucked your dick, you know, when you was a square before you got in the game and a bitch sucked your dick, her head might have been boring. She might didn't know what she was doing, but I'm not going to tell her that. I'm going to make this bitch thinking that, you know what I mean? Like, whew. You know what I mean? After giving her so many compliments, she gonna think, you understand me, that she the coldest motherfucker that ever gave head before. That's how you supposed to make your woman feel. You give her inspiration to keep going in that same location, man. What location? My dick. So, you know, when you was a square, you didn't say, oh man, your head was terrible, bitch. You know what I mean? Just give it up. No. You gave her compliment after compliment. You blew her head up. You gave her all the encouragement that she needed to continue on giving you head. So, okay, in the game, you know what I mean? When a bitch sit up there and catch her first date, she might have called her first date for $250. Guess what? I'm going to blow that $250 up to be a billion. When that bitch sit up there and call, hey, check it out. That bitch could have gave some head for $150. And that bitch sat up there and called that phone, And she said, I did my first date. Oh my God. Okay. Okay, bitch. Yeah. That's the fuck I'm talking about. Yeah. You know what I mean? Now she's smiling and everything. Oh, it wasn't even as bad. I didn't think. I thought it would be so bad, but like, wow, it was nothing like in the movies or what I seen on Netflix. It wasn't nothing like them documentaries. It wasn't like nothing like the news and things like that. Oh my God, I can't believe that I did. Yeah, baby, you did it. You know what I mean? Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Hey. But check it out though. I already knew that you had it in you. That's why I gave you, you know what I mean, the game. That's, listen, tonight is just the beginning, baby. It's just the beginning. Oh my God, you blowing my head. And then I already knew the way you walked out the door, I knew you was gonna check it. Cause you looking so good tonight. I started to go up in that thing before I had even sent you. Oh my God, stop. Seriously, I did. You know, I had to fight the feeling. I had to really fight it. I said, no, I ain't gonna do all of that. You know what I mean? Cause you and you was getting ready and things like that. I was like, man, I could just tear her up right now, you know? Oh my God, you're trying to blow my head. No, I'm being serious. You know, the way you look right now, you just look like no trick until you know, baby. You know what I mean? But yeah, go ahead and finish, you know, taking care of that. You know, put some sanitizer on, wash your hands, baby, and go catch another one, you know? And, you know, and I mean, hey, everybody get down different. You know what I mean? But when you dealing, you know, with a broad, a square broad, especially with a spiritual background, I'm going to pray for the bitch before I send her. You know what I mean? And, you know, hey, every P get down different, man. You know? But like I tell every hoe, hey, man, when you alone with that trick, you got my instructions. You know what I mean? But honestly, I'm not physically there. So it's you and that trick and the mercies of God. You know what I mean? It's just you, baby, the trick and the mercies of God. So, you know what I mean? When we acknowledge God, when you sit up there, you understand me, and send her out, you know, because with the words, I mean, like I said, everybody's different. But now you done sent the hoe out with confidence, you know what I mean? She know that God gonna bring her back safely with the activity of her limbs. You know, nothing's gonna happen to her. And see, I'm speaking from the perspective of somebody that's been in the game since 2007, and no hoe has ever got killed under my watch. I'd be a liar if I tell you that a hoe never got robbed or raped. Cause I done had some hoes, you know what I mean, that got robbed. I done had some hoes that got raped. But I ain't never had a hoe that got killed. I never had a hoe that was badly beaten. You know, never. You know, them two right there, I never had them encounters. And by the mercies of God, you know, hopefully I will never. But just moving on. Like I said, that little bride that y'all seen on that video when all the little squares was crying, the bitch was trash. You know what I mean? I'll tell you, I'll give you another one, right? And I say beautiful trash because I could just go on and on and on. I'm doing my best not to make this a long ass video. I'm really, but I got so many areas, man, that I could sit up there and just go into. You know what I mean? As far as beautiful trash. You know what I mean? Seriously, I might have to make a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but another thing, you know what I mean? Another time, and I'm just speaking about me tonight, you know what I mean? The little broad that you guys seen, some of y'all seen, right? You know, and I'm not trying to go in on her, you know? But some of y'all, you know, seen a video of me on my way to the Educational Center Convention in Naperville. Right now, man, I'm teaching right now. I kind of don't like when you guys be asking questions when I'm teaching. When I sit up there, you know what I mean, and I open up the phone lines, you know, call and ask me a question then. But while I'm teaching, it ain't like I'm about to get out the groove of teaching and stop what I'm doing, you know what I mean, especially nothing like that. So just call in and ask me, and I bless you. But yeah, the little bride that you seen me on my way to Naperville with, when I was the guest speaker at the Educational Center Convention, the bitch from Australia, yeah, the bitch that was outside, that told the police, you know what I mean? Like, he put his hand on me, but she didn't have no mark, no nothing. You know what I mean? Now, let's rewind, as you know, we don't fuck with each other no more. But when I got that broad, first of all, I was in Minnesota. I was campaigning in Bloomington. Had a room in Bloomington. You know how I do it in Minnesota, man. I'm going to go get a room in Bloomington. And nighttime, I'm going to be in that downtown Minneapolis. But daytime, I'm going to be in that Bloomington. Sometime I might be in that St. Paul. You know, another good area. You know what I mean? When you're in that Minnesota, you want to go to Apple Valley. My God. There's nothing but gorgeous, beautiful women there. For all the guys that like beautiful black women who are articulate, educated, that look like, you know, they just look like they pussy smell like the Garden of Eden, man. You know what I mean? And she just come from a two-parent home. She was raised from church. Apple Valley. You know what I mean? Apple Valley, nigga. So, you know, I was in Minnesota campaigning. Me and this broad, and this is what I told you guys to be knowledgeable about, you know, music. You know, be knowledgeable about other things outside of the game, because one of the best ways to get a woman in your lifestyle is to be knowledgeable about life. You know, a lot of times you guys, Facebook, Instagram, it don't be cracking. You know, I don't do that shit no more, but if I wanted to, you know, like I used to, you get Facebook cracking just by making statuses about life, inspirational statuses, comical statuses, intellectual statuses, challenging people's religious beliefs, you know, asking questions to cause a debate, and then smashing people in the comment section. You know, it's just, it's easy. And by you showing your intellectualism, you know, for all the sapiosexual women that's in the comment section, they pussy gonna get wet and they ain't even physically around you because of the intellect that you conveying. You know what I mean? And you might not even be her physical preference, but she's attracted to brilliance. She's attracted to intelligence. So by you having that, you know, man, now y'all in the comment section talking, and you go from the comment section to the inbox, to the phone, from the phone to actually meeting each other. Now you got it. And it sounds so easy, but man, I done it so many times because of something that I said. Matter of fact, no, I said something in the comment section on my nigga Wook page. Those of you that remember, I did an interview with Wook, OTF Wook, and the founder of OTF, really. But, you know, I was talking to Wook, and she seen that, and when she seen how Wook and others in the comment section had acknowledged me as the pimpin', she got curious. She goes to my page, and she see a certain song, and I forgot what it was, but she gets in my DM and she had asked me, you know, what song is that? And so, you know, make a long story short, you know, we started talking about music. Now we on the phone laughing and all that type of shit. And come to find out, this bitch can sing. This Australian ass bitch can sing. She sung that Brandy, I Wanna Be Down. And she sounded cool, real cool. You know what I mean? So I sung to her, she sung to me, and we just started vibing. And we built it on music. And we went from talking about music, to sharing poetry. And now we went from talking about music to poetry to now talking about religion, you know? And so now, you know what I mean? And so now you went from that, and now you're asking me questions about me now. Now you want to know more about my lifestyle. Now I got you intrigued, you know? So, but it all started with music. Make a long story short, man, she was out there in that Tennessee. And this is what I mean by, and some of you guys are just like me. You know, when you just did everything for a bitch, it's like, bitch, you wouldn't even sit up there, you understand me, and have nothing, no nothing, if it wasn't for me. I forgot the little town that this bitch was even in Tennessee. This bitch was in the middle of nowhere. You know what I mean? This bitch was on a fucking farm, bro, with horses and all of this type of cows and motherfucking animals and shit all around here in Tennessee, bro. You know what I'm saying? So I had the bitch leave because she was on this farm with this white guy getting fucked on for free. You know what I mean? He just fucking her every day. You know, he having a good time. She ain't got nowhere to go. He just on the farm, you know, getting his dick sucked, fucking, you know, feeding his cows and having a real good time, right? So I have the bitch sit up there, you understand me, and meet me up in Nashville. So we sit up there, you understand me, and meet up in Nashville, you know, face to face. And I already knew, you know what I mean? I had her. You know what I mean? I had her. Bro said Chattanooga. No, it wasn't Chattanooga. It was somewhere else, man. I'm talking about this was in, that place was in the middle of nowhere. But anyway, I end up having the bride. We leave Nashville and hit Chicago. You know what I mean? And man, lace that bitch, man. And I'm just gonna keep it all the way 100, man. I don't never lie on nobody's reputation. Hey, that bitch sat up there, you understand me, and took a hold of that shit. You know, as easy as breathing air. You know what I mean? Like drinking water. You know, I told her how to do things in the city of Chicago. Man, please. Nigga, we was at the, I'm at the buffet table, nigga, you understand? You know what I mean when I say that. I'm not at the salad bar. I'm at the buffet table in downtown Chicago, really eating in that motherfucking Magnificent Mile. You know? So, at that time, these was actually some cool times because, you know, Freeze had sit up there and, nah, that ain't it either. But Freeze had sit up there and came up on some new work. You know, he doing his thing. My other P partner, he had just came up on a little lick, you know, and man, I lied to you not. The bitch didn't even, she wasn't even in Chicago a whole week, you know what I mean, before she had sat up there and grabbed her first watch, you know what I mean? Then after a watch, you know what I mean? Because I told her how to do certain scare tactics. You know what I mean? Because I just know certain areas, they be scared. Matter of fact, I ain't going to get that game up. Y'all got to pay for that game. Or maybe I might put that on my Patreon. But anyway, she had got into a little situation. I gave her some information on how to do things. She was successful at doing that. And she just kept on and kept on and kept on. This is the same bitch that I gave her the game on how to basically terrorize, you know, Paradise Valley and Scottsdale and, you know what I mean, that type of shit. And, you know, I can go on and on and on. But making a long story short, that bitch didn't appreciate none of that shit, man. I had that, look, I took this bitch off of a farm. You went from, you went from being on a farm to now living in Scottsdale. I ain't gonna lie on the bitch. I just knew your whole attire, everything. It didn't even amount to $150. And now I got you sitting over there, you understand me, in certain areas that I'm not gonna name. But now, you know what I mean? You sitting over there, you understand me, coming out 3,000 this, 4,000 this now. You know what I mean? Bitch didn't appreciate none of that. I told Freeze, like, bro, I took this bitch off of a farm. Like, I said, now, my pimpin' then took, you know, bitches off the couch of they mama. My pimpin' then took bitches from, you understand me, working a minimum wage job. I done took bitches out of the Waffle House, all of this shit. But, bitch, I took you off of a motherfucking farm, ho. You need to be giving God praise and magnifying him, bitch, the day you met me, bitch. You was on a fucking farm with cows and horses and shit and pigs, bitch. You need to thank God the day that I was made, ho. This is just keeping that thing 100. But yeah, man, you know, trash. Beautiful trash. P, what you mean by that? Even before that incident that y'all had seen, the giving you the backstory of that, the reason why we had started bumping heads, because the bitch started drinking. You know what I mean? The bitch started drinking and all of that, started drinking with tricks and all of that. And was the bitch making some money? Yes. But see, when you dealing with a motherfucker like me, you got to be in full compliance. I'm not one of them individuals. Oh, what you do? Oh, you got 3,700, but you was disobedient. You know what I mean? Oh, you sit up there and sniff the line with a trick. You know what I mean? But you got 5,000. Oh, okay. I ain't gonna say nothing. I'm not that nigga. I can give a less fuck what you made. If I tell you to do something, that's the fuck I told you to do. Because I got sense enough to know that the same way that this game is working with you, it can work with her, 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 and her, and her. Bitch, I created you. You're a thought out of my motherfucking mind that's being manifested right now. That's how, you know, I'm just keeping that real. I already know that some people, oh my God, sin just full of himself. I got this bitch off of a fucking farm. Like, come on, man. You know, and we got to be 100, you know, even with your kids. This bitch had never been, I'm not going to go. I'm just showing you how to pimp and be. This is exactly how to pimp and be, though. This not just sinful. This is pimps. Pimps be taking better care of these bitches' kids than they be taking care of their own kids, bro. But the pimpin' get painted to be a monster, but he really been a blessing to the children of this trashy-ass bitch. Now, the reason why that incident that you seen, that domestic violence case that had got dropped, you know what I mean, because that was a lie. I had not even shook the bitch hand. I didn't touch that bitch. But the reason for that was, is prior to that, the bitch was getting flip mouth with me because she was drunk over the phone. And I was like, damn, bitch, you been drinking again? She was like, you don't appreciate nothing. You don't appreciate nothing. No matter how much money I give you, no matter how what I do, no matter how many watches I give you, you would think you'd be happy. So what if I had a little drink here and there? You're just gonna take the money anyway. So what if I just wanna have a good time? Everybody can't be like you. You want me to be, you know, a Catholic priest or a nun or something. You don't drink, you don't smoke. I don't want to be like that. You want to make me into a fucking nun. You know what I'm saying? I said, bitch, because anybody that know me knows that if a bitch had an excellent night or if it's her birthday, I let a bitch smoke something. I'll let a bitch drink something, but to be drinking and smoking with the trick, oh, that's a no-no. That's a no-no. You getting high with the trick? Wait a minute. You getting crucial conflict, hay in the middle of the barn with a trick? Bitch, no. That's not how sin get out. So the bitch getting real flip mouth. Like, I'm like, okay, bitch. All right, bitch, shut up. Okay, bitch, shut up. And she's still, nah, you always want me to shut up. I don't want to shut up. I don't want to shut up. How about that? I don't want to shut up. I'll reach through this phone, bitch, and grab your motherfucking lungs out, bitch, you understand me, and play double dutch with it. Bitch, don't sit up there, you understand me, and play with me, bitch. You're not gonna do nothing. Shut up. I was like, whoa. What? Did this bitch from the farm just sit up there and tell me that? So I hung up the phone. The bitch kept on just calling me. And so I answered. She's like, okay, since you want to be such a smart aleck, and since you want to be a smart ass about the situation, I'm not gonna, because usually this bitch sound Australian, but now she sounds like a fucking drunk ass white girl. She sounds like a fucking bum. The bitch just, I'm not coming home tonight. I was like, okay, well, bitch, whatever. If you want us to go, whatever you go, I'm gonna do what I want to do. You're not my fucking father, okay? I want to get a fucking drink. That's what I'm going to do. That's what I'm going to do. And so I will see you tomorrow. You think that you're somebody's father. You're not my dad. You're my pimp, okay? I will talk to you later. All right, bitch, get your bum ass off my phone. Goodbye. So, beautiful trash. Beautiful trash. Did the bitch make money? Yes. When the bitch put on her makeup and when she put on certain attire, was she attractive? Yes. And y'all know how I am. You know, if a bitch is a hoe, I ain't say a square prostitute, but I ain't never seen an ugly hoe. Yeah, I seen some ugly bitches. I seen some ugly square prostitutes. I seen some ugly trash, but I ain't never seen no ugly hoe. You know, I ain't never seen an ugly. Every hoe that I've ever seen was beautiful to me. What is a hoe? A woman who complies and applies the information, the instructions of the instructor, which is a pimp, each and every day. A hoe is a woman that gets up each and every day and say, what can I do greater than what I did yesterday? How could I pay pimping even more? What can I do to give more loyalty, to get bring more currency, to bring more hoes to the family? This is the mindset. This is the mentality of a hoe. What sacrifices do I have to make so I can be more attractive, to make more clients attentive to my attractive appearance? This is the mindset of a hoe. Let me study some watches, because I need to know every watch. You know what I mean? As soon as I see this, well, I need to know the value of it. So let me study some watches. Let me study attire of men, so I know an expensive suit when I see one. Because every suit that we think that's ugly or like, ugh, that suit might cost $30,000. So I need that same suit that everybody was laughing at. You know, that might be that white man that got us dressed all weird. He got on some shit that's cost more than somebody's car. I need to study attire. I need to study this. I need to study watches and rings. I need to study the value of this, the value of that. This is the mindset of a hoe. That bitch, I mean, let me sit up there and text this bitch. Because it was a bitch, she was getting real loose. She was talking about how, why I'm always happy, why I'm always joyful and things like that. I need to tell her the reason why I'm so joyful is because I get joy from an unlimited supply called pimping. Yeah. When you see my countenance, when you see my appearance, it's because I'm messing with an intelligent, heaven-sent, infinite-minded embodiment of joy, pimping motherfucker. That's why I'm like that. And you should be fucking with him too. That's the mind of a hoe. So, once again, I've never seen an unattractive hoe. I've seen some ugly bitches. I've seen some ugly square prostitutes. But bitch, if you a hoe, you fine as hell to me. I can give a less fuck what color you are. I can give a less fuck what size you are. You could be skinny. You could be fat. You could be tall. You could be short, but if you a hoeing motherfucker, bitch, you fine as a motherfucker to me with your fine ass. Every fine ass hoe right now, get into my DM. SINFULTHEP 77. Blessings to all the hoes. You know what I mean? Because I've seen plenty of ugly bitches within my 36 years of living. I ain't never seen no ugly hoe. You know what I mean? But I've seen a lot of beautiful trash, though. And that's what we have in the game today. When you go on Instagram, you can go right now. You can see unknockable Stacy. You can see unknockable Stasha. Untouchable 304 this. 304 Big Booty Tasha. 304 _ always getting it, you know, Nathaya. You know, you could go on Instagram right now, you know what I mean, and look at She's Always At It _ 304 Sasha, you know what I mean? She's Always In A Tricks Face Brenda, you know what I mean? You're going to see all of these bitches, right? But when that bitch go live, and when you see them just smoking and sounding stupid and dumb, trash. Trash. You know, you might look at a bitch and see her pictures on Instagram right now and be like, man, this is some work. Oh my God, this bitch is some work. If I knock this bitch, ooh wee, a pimp about to be on. Then the bitch sit up there, you understand me, and go live. And then you listening to the bitch, and she tell you, she's like, well, you know, these niggas ain't shit because I had a situation because, you know, I had to call the police on my last P. And everybody just, and we in the era now where people will just go past that like the bitch didn't, like the bitch just didn't say that. And by these niggas being so thirsty and so hungry to just have a bitch that's beautiful on the outside, but she's beautiful trash, they gonna say anything and everything and just walk past what this bitch just said. The bitch just said up there, she could be like, you know, because my last folks, he wanted to let us go out there and hoe in the snow. I was like, I'm not about to hoe in the snow. Uh-uh. That's gonna mess up my shoes. And it's cold outside. Boy, you tripping. And he was like, bitch, you gonna respect my pimping or you gonna leave? I was like, how am I gonna sit up there and leave? I'm with you. I'm with you, Tavon the pimp. Don't sit up there and let me out. Why are you acting like this, Tavon the pimp? And he sit up there and like, you out of pocket, bitch. And he called me a fag. I was like, oh, I'll teach him. Since you gonna call me out of pocket, I'ma sit up there and get you in pocket. I called the police, baby. Yes, I did. And we are in an era right now that a bitch could be a police caller. She could be all of these things, but guess what? Let that bitch be a white bitch. Let her be light-skinned with a nice body. Let that bitch, I mean, she could even be brown or dark with it, but especially if she's a white bitch or she's so light, close to white, with a nice marketable body, niggas will hear that this bitch told on their best peep partner and still be in the comment section, still campaigning to have this beautiful trash. Beautiful trash. Bitch ain't no goddamn hoe. And let me say that let me make this very clear. If you've ever told on somebody, if you are the reason right now that a pimp or pimps is walking the yard right now, a prison yard right now, doing a prison sentence, I don't give a fuck how much money you making. I don't care who you paying right now, what foreign you driving, what designer clothes you may have. You know what I mean? Bitch, you're trash. You a snitch. And you can't be a snitch and be this hoeing. I keep telling y'all, let's put some honor on that hoeing. Stop calling everybody a hoe. Let them make the real hoes feel blessed and honored to be a hoe. You know what I mean? Stop calling anybody and everybody a goddamn hoe. Everybody is not a hoe. That's another thing I'm tired of. I'm tired of motherfucking bitches leaving the game and getting married and sitting up there get married and shit. And after the marriage fall apart, the bitch just come back to the game like all her a hoe and shit like that. That ain't cool. That ain't cool. Yeah, we got to stop all these double standards. That ain't cool either. Bitch leaving the game, she married and shit. Yeah, now the marriage done fell apart. Now she ready to just come back. And she done did this to the game more than once. 2-3 motherfucking times. Every time she sit up there and fall out with a P, she sit up there and go get her girlfriend and a boyfriend. She might sit up there and make money. But stop calling her a hoe. That's not what she is. She's not a hoe. Hold on. There we go. She might be a square prostitute. She could be a marketable, attractive square prostitute. But she's not a hoe. Stop calling her that. You know? And another thing. You know what I mean? Man, like I said, man, I'm doing my best to not sit up there and make this. But when I keep thinking about, man, when I keep thinking about beautiful trash, like I could just go on and on and on and on. You know what I mean? Some of y'all, young peas, the reason right now why things are not so prosperous because you keep holding on to that bitch that's the best definition of cancerous right now. That bitch is cancerous to your pimping. She's not doing anything. She's not doing anything that's beneficial. She running bitches away. Oh, man. God damn, man. I'm really trying to not make this video long. But the bitch running bitches away. She's sitting over there lying on another. You got bitches that will actually lie on a bitch, make the bitch look bad. She trying to do anything and everything, you understand me, to run this bitch off. You know what I mean? And if you're a stupid motherfucker, if you allow this bitch to sit up there and dictate or do anything, because I've seen situations like that where a bitch, she's sitting up there causing all this chaos, all of this drama. She running bitches off. And then by the time this goofy nigga come to the realization to get rid of the bitch, he didn't allow the bitch to run off the other bitches. So by the time he got rid of this bitch, now he holus and dolus. That's crazy. I'm talking real experience right now. I know somebody that actually, this was actually somebody. Sin, what are you talking about? Man, listen. The nigga that I'm talking about sat up there and knocked a good bitch. And he knocked her. I hate to say this, but I got to tell the truth. He sat up there and knocked the bitch off of that site. I don't want to say the name, but he knocked that bitch off that site that all the pimps and hoes used to be on. That site that I told y'all about that all the pimps was going live on. Before Facebook, Instagram was going live, this site that pimps and hoes was on was going live way before, you know what I mean, Facebook, Instagram, and all of that shit. A good hoe. But because he allowed this bitch that he was attracted to, I don't know why he was attracted to this bitch. She's trash to me because I look beyond just the physical appearance. You know what I mean? The bitch, she just very destructive. That bitch ugly as hell to me. You know what I mean? I don't give a fuck what a bitch look like physically. After you learn a person and learn, you know what I mean, the things that they do to others to make others feel, you know, miserable. Because they're miserable, like, no, this bitch is not attractive. But make a long story short, he ended up sitting over there, you understand me, knocking, you know what I mean, this thief. So as he sat up there, you understand me, and knocked this motherfucking thief bitch, you know, I ain't gonna lie. When she first got there, you know what I mean, she was checking it. I ain't gonna sit up there and lie. She was checking it when she first got there. That bitch gave that nigga a little bit over 80-something thousand. You know what I mean? Within, I think, 2 to 3 weeks. All right? Follow me now. I know some of y'all squares, y'all like, wait a minute. She what? But yeah, man, that's true. The bitch sat up there, you understand me, and gave that nigga a little bit over 80,000 within a 2 week or 3 week period. That's true. But after that 2 or 3 weeks, man, shit went downhill. You know, she was just, you know, every now and then she'd do a little something. But he, because this bitch was a thief, he allowed this bitch to just say anything and everything to his other bitches. The thief bitch used to sit up there and talk to that good hoe that he used to have, you know, and used to try to make her feel bad, you know, because she was selling pussy. You know what I mean? And he allowed this. He allowed this beautiful trash to just come up in his household and just be disruptive. He allowed this beautiful trash to create rumors and lies in the household. He allowed this shit. You know, and let me just say this. A lot of these bitches actually are beautiful trash because you niggas produce that. If we gonna keep that all the way 100. Some of these bitches are trash because that's what you niggas produced. Remember, a woman gonna produce what a man introduced her to. And I don't want to sit up there and go into that, but I'm not, because of your conduct. If we really gonna keep it all the way 100. But whenever there's no pimping, there will be no hoeing. And what ended up happening is the bitch, the thief bitch, she runs off the good hoe and the other little, because I think he had three others, but he might have just had two others. But the thief, she ran the whole household away. And by the time this nigga finally realized that I just want peace, I just want serenity, I don't want to do this no more. You know what I mean? I don't want to fight no more. You know what I mean? Because now you fighting the bitch. Y'all getting into fist fights. You know what I mean? You fighting the bitch before she go to work. You know, and some of y'all listening to me, you know what I'm talking about. One minute you feeling joyful. One minute you feeling happy. But every time you come around this bitch, it's like she searches for misery. The bitch searches for a misunderstanding. She searches for, you know, anything that she can find. She's a problematic bitch. She searches for problems when there's no problems. She likes drama. If there's too much peace going on, it's too much laughter, it's too many smiling faces, everybody happy, she's uncomfortable. She's uncomfortable. Bitches smiling and all of that, you know, joyful, no. Another hoe made a joke and the pimpin' laughed at it, she's offended. The bitch is highly upset. She's mad. Trash. Bitch ain't no hoe. That's trash. Hold on. Let me see. And what did I tell you pimps? What did I tell the young pimping? You got to protect your pimp energy at all costs. Remember what I told you. You got to protect that pimp energy at all costs. Drew, good looking for the 10. I appreciate that, bro. Good looking. Hold on. Vanessa, appreciate the 30. Good looking. I haven't even been paying attention to these cash apps. Good looking, man. I appreciate them cash apps. That's what's up. But, you know, she basically was able to run his household. And by the time he came to the realization that he wanted to maintain his energy, he finally wanted some peace. You know what I mean? Everybody was to now having this new bitch, and now you don't got them. You don't got them hoes no more, and you don't even got the thief bitch no more. All of that could have been avoided. When you finally listen, when you first realize and recognize that a bitch is trash, get rid of it. Don't maintain no trash around you just because she's attractive. She look good. What the fuck that got to do with some pimping? You sitting over there maintaining this bitch because she sat up there and gave you a watch in 1936. That's what's up. I'm glad that she gave you a Rolex. I'm glad that she gave you 87,000 in 1936, but it's 2000 and such and such now. What has she done lately? What currency has she given lately? You know, and man, like I said, that's a perfect example of, by the time he came to the realization that, man, I done lost everything. I done lost, you know, these hoes. And then this bitch, she ain't even producing the way she used to produce. You know what I mean? Like, fuck. Now you went from having it your way to now being by yourself. And now you got to call the pimping and ask the pimping for a jug. Because you didn't not only pimp correctly, but you didn't even preside over your money correctly. Hold on. Here we go. Once you come to the realization that a bitch is trash, once she shows you that she's trash, man, what do we do with trash? Do you let trash stay in your house? Let me ask you that. Do you allow trash to stay in your house? Why would you something cancerous around you? The scripture even speaks in Hebrews, lay aside every weight that so easily beset you. Why would you hold on to this dead weight? Why would you hold on to something that's cancerous? Why would you hold on to something that's dangerous? Why would you hold on to something that's hindering you from being prosperous in the game? Why are you holding on to that bitch? Some of y'all been holding on to trash for for 2 years, 5 years, 7 years, 8 years. That you've been maintaining this trash for 8 years. You know, I'm just keeping that thing all the way 100. Some people only got the benefit of saying that they've been maintaining some trash for 8 and 10 years. Give you another perfect example. I've told you this once before, but some of y'all got to remember that time when I had Freeze, and it was another P that was in the comment section. He even knew who I was talking about. But it's this one motherfucker, right? And he don't like me, and I don't really give a fuck for him. But he's in Vegas. And me and him, you know, we've bumped heads plenty of times. But he's been maintaining this beautiful trash since ever since I've known him. And I've known him since 2007. And he's still maintaining that beautiful trash. He can't have another hole because he's maintaining beautiful trash. He can't even sit up there, you understand me, and enjoy himself with the pimping because he's got too many problems with beautiful trash. So I'm gonna give you an example. This bitch, you not only is disrespectful to him, but you already know, if a bitch is disrespectful to her man, you already know she gonna be disrespectful. Well, let me change that. If a bitch is disrespectful to her male that's supposed to be a man, you know that she gonna sit up there and have courage to be disrespectful and disruptive to other men. Because this bitch is so disrespectful, she would disrespect this man in front of the pimping. She even smacked him one time at the Heart Bar in Planet Hollywood in front of the pimping. Another P had to break the shit up. She went off on him at the Heart Bar in Planet Hollywood. Them, they used to sit up there all the time and get into it. But he's maintaining that. And he wants to be really, I remember one time, right? I almost had a stroke. And the reason why I had almost had a stroke, because this nigga, of course, I wasn't physically there, because if I was physically there, I would have gave this nigga the roasting of a lifetime. But he had told somebody else, he said, I'm not, this is the nigga that called me corny. This is the same nigga that allowed his bitch to smack him in front of the pimping. In front of the pimping. I'm corny, but you getting smacked by another hoe. I mean, by a hoe. Yeah, well, another hoe, because he got to be, he's the hoe too. But, you know, you getting smacked in front of the pimping, but I'm corny. So I should be fly like you, huh? That shit crazy. Bitch sitting over there smack. To just be perfectly honest, the bitch was disrespectful like Gucci Man. The bitch sitting over there giving this nigga that Gucci Man disrespect. She giving him that Gucci Man disrespect. Seeing what you mean, what's that Gucci Man disrespect? The same disrespect that Gucci Man was giving at the Versus, that bitch was sitting over there being disrespectful. When Gucci, like, you know what I mean, put that nigga in the dirt, smoking on Pookie Loke. If you send any more of them niggas, I'ma send them back to you in a box. And the same, I tell you what. Bitch smacking this nigga, all smack this nigga in his face in front of the pimp. I tell you what. You know what I mean? Bitch sit up there and smacked him out. He had got out of pocket with the bitch. The bitch smacked him back in pocket. And this nigga at the Heart Bar in front of pimps, embarrassed. Come on, man. Bitch sitting over there giving that Gucci Man disrespect in front of the pimping. Did he check the bitch? No. Why does he still have that bitch? Because he's used to having trash. He's cool with having trash. Hold on for a minute. There we go. You know what I mean? He's cool with having trash. He's done everything and anything to maintain that trash. You know what I mean? You can't really roast a bitch like that, even though she is trash, but he gave her a license to be trash. And you know what's fucked up? She fits that description perfectly. Because she, when you look at her physically, she's very attractive. But guess what? Guess what? She's trash. And what's so cold about it, you understand me? Oh, and that's what I didn't sit up there and bring to the motherfucking table. When the Pippin has set up there, hey, Helena, when the Pippin has set up there, you understand me, and told him, like, man, how this bitch get so comfortable, P, where she getting disrespectful with you and she going back and forth with P's like she equal with the Pippin? What are you doing at your home? Like, what's going on? This bitch done got out of pocket with pimps. This bitch done paid other pimps. This bitch done smacked him, but he's still maintaining her. And this is what I mean by that. Listen, to you young peas, right? These niggas will tell you, oh man, I've been maintaining my hoe, man. This hoe been down for my crown for 10 years. Or this hoe been down for my crown for 13 years. This hoe been down for my crown for 15 and 20 years. But see, what they don't tell you, because I know this game like that, what they don't tell you is when the hoe left off for 2 months to pay somebody else. What they don't tell you is when that hoe left off for 3 months to go stay at her mama house when she was in her feelings. What they don't tell you is when that bitch sat up there and left them, and the bitch was sitting over there working at TGF Fridays and shit. You understand me? She was working there for 5 months. That's what they don't, they forget to tell you. They just make it seem like the bitch basically just been down a whole 10 and 13 years with no stops. They don't sit up there and tell you, well, you know, the bitch, you know, originally she got with me at such and such, such and such, but between that time, she got knocked a few times. The bitch sat up there, you understand me, and went here a few times, or the bitch did this, or the bitch. No, they just gonna tell you that I've been having the bitch for 15, 20 years, but they not gonna tell you that this bitch done been knocked. They're not gonna tell you that this bitch done blew up. They just gonna make it appear as if their pimping has been just so spectacular that this bitch didn't wanna go nowhere else, you know. When, and another thing I wanna say, when these niggas tell you that they've been holding on to a bitch or maintaining the bitch for 10, 15, 20 motherfucking years, you know what I mean? You have to think to yourself, especially if you haven't pimped side by side with this man, you got to understand, these niggas have done things with these bitches that we would never do. Hold on. Okay, Queen, I see you with the five. Sebastian, good looking on the Cash App. You know what I mean? I appreciate every Cash App that's came in. Blessings to everybody. But they don't tell you about all of these things. They don't tell you about, you know, that hoe that they glorifying and exalting to be superwoman, the hoe. You know what I mean? How this bitch, you know, was getting high off meth, or she was sitting over there getting high with tricks and shit at that time. Listen, man, all I'm saying is it ain't all what it seems. All I'm saying is once you find out, once the game show you that this bitch is trash, leave her the fuck alone. Once the game show you that this bitch is cancer, leave it alone. Why? Because cancer will kill you. As you keep holding on to that cancer, you will be killed. Certain people are just existing in the game. They're not living. They're getting a little bit of currency, or they might even be getting some big currency, but there's no serenity there. He don't have serenity with his currency because the bitch keep giving him a continuity of innumerable problems. Every time she hit it in the lick that she hit, it's not even worth it. Some of y'all listening to this message, you already know. You should have been let that cancer go. You would have been set up there and knocked you a new young team by now. Hold on. The game want to sit up there and bless you. It's a new population of hoes that need you. It's some beautiful, marketable hoes that's willing to do what you say, when you say, how you say. You're holding on to this cancer. You're holding on to somebody that don't want to sit up there and see you win, man. You holding on to somebody who chases misery. Yeah, Queen, that's why I said good looking on the Cash App. Yeah. Yeah, I got it, Queen. Blessings to you. You know what I mean? You're holding on to somebody that's miserable and wants you to be miserable with her. And even though I'm talking to young pimps right now, you know what I mean? For you players, for you squares, some of y'all done been in relationships with different females that profess to be women that was cancer to you, but you still stand in this situationship. You can't even produce your greatness. It's so much greatness that you have within you. You got up that day saying, I was going to work out. I'm going to read. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. Only to get into an argument that drained you for all your energy that you had to sit up there, you understand me, and put your best foot forward towards greatness. You allowed that miserable spirit to stay around you. You can't flourish. You can't sit up there and replenish yourself. You can't sit up there, you understand me, and get to where you need to be mentally. Because you holding on to this motherfucking ass bitch that she don't want to see you prosper. She know you wanted to work out. She knew you wanted to read. She knew that you wanted some time to yourself to meditate. But instead of allowing you to meditate, allowing you to read to educate yourself, she's looking for problems. She's looking for situations. She's looking for a misunderstanding. Hey, man, you don't need nobody like that. You don't need nobody like that. Anybody that does not want to see you win, what did I tell you? Anybody that does not bless your income, anybody that does not bless your outcome, why do you welcome this individual? You got to lay aside these toxic friendships and associations and things like that. You're getting ready to go into a whole nother motherfucking year. And if you don't sit up there, you understand me, and let go of this toxic friendship, this toxic association, you're not going to. Some of y'all have been blessed with some ministries and some gifts that's going to be a blessing to me and others. But we can't sit up there and enjoy the gift that God has blessed you to have because you got so much negativity and so many toxic people around you. So we'll never be able to enjoy the manifestation of the gift that God deposited in you because you want to keep holding on to this cancer. Pete, what cancer that? That beautiful trash that you got. Yeah. Some of y'all got a wife that's beautiful trash. Some of y'all got a girlfriend that's beautiful trash. Some of y'all got a so-called hoe that's beautiful trash. I'm not just sitting over there talking to, I'm hitting everybody upside the head with this game. And just because that's a woman's legs in that picture, some of you women, you know what I mean? You can't flourish. You can't even sit up there and manifest what God put in you. Cause you holding on to some old Nicky Knack ass nigga that don't, he ain't official. He ain't beneficial. He don't got nothing to teach you. He don't uplift you. He don't got no enlightenment to give you. He don't got no encouragement to give you. He don't got nothing to give you. Look at your body. Look at your mind. Look at your spirit. Everything about you is to take in. Sin, what are you talking about? Meaning that you're supposed to be with a man that's able to deposit something into you. The gift that you have, woman, you can take what a man has and make it greater. So a man might have something good, but no matter how good he made it, man, once a woman get a hold of to it, it becomes something else. It becomes greater. But you're not with the right man, so you'll never find out the greatness that's within you. Because you holding on to some Nicky Knack ass nigga. The nigga ain't making you come up. He ain't making you come. This is a waste of time. This is clearly a waste of time. Listen to the way that sound. He hasn't been, you've been with this nigga for years. You understand me? Now, some of you women, you've been in some shit. And the reason why it's not flourishing is because of you. It's not the man. You know what I mean? Y'all used to fuck. Y'all used to talk. Y'all used to get along. Y'all used to laugh. But you're not willing to deal with the things you said, the things you did to make that man not be attracted to you no more. You want to sit up there and manipulate yourself and deceive yourself into thinking that it's something that he did when, bitch, you refuse to take any motherfucking accountability for your motherfucking faggot ass actions. Don't die a fag. Life is too short to die a fag. Touch your neighbor and say, life is too short to die a fag. You don't want to die a faggot ass bitch. You don't want to die a maggot ass bitch. This is the day that the Lord has made. He didn't wake you up to be a problematic punk ass bitch. That's not why he woke you up this morning. And I know it's hard to have integrity. I know it's hard to have some accountability. But my goodness, woman, you know, make a step forward towards it. Because sooner or later, if you don't start taking some accountability for your actions, pretty soon that man is going to start looking elsewhere. Like, damn, this bitch, she want to sit up there. All this bitch, every time I come around her, man, she ain't got nothing but negativity. You know what I mean? And then when I address it, when I, you know what I mean, try to encourage her to acknowledge, you know what I mean, her faults, her frailties, her insecurities, you know, her iniquities, things that she done said and did that was contrary to what is right. She don't have no integrity. She can't take no accountability. Why would I get into a continuity of being in this? I got to go elsewhere. I'm looking for mental climaxes. I'm looking for a woman that can stimulate me. I don't want to sit up there like, God, it's just good to have a woman, you know what I mean, that got that same consuming fire within her that I have. You know what I mean? We building each other. But each and every time, it's like every day I got to give an encouragement speech. I got to give a Martin Luther King speech to this bitch, you know, to get her out this pool of depression that she's in every day. It's getting draining. It's like, damn. The bitch is in a pool of misery and she trying to grab my hand and push me into that motherfucker. Bitch, I'm not trying to come in that pool of misery with you. You got to stay in that motherfucker by yourself. Hit that like button. Get my likes over 500. Get them likes over 500. Everybody hit that like button. If you're not subscribed to the channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button. Make sure you click on the bell. If you are already subscribed to the channel and you haven't been receiving notifications, what you might want to do is unsubscribe from the channel, then subscribe again and click on the bell. Once again, if you're already subscribed to the channel, but you haven't been getting notifications when I go live or post, what you would want to do is unsubscribe from the channel and then subscribe to the channel once again and click on the bell. And once again, my Instagram account, it's SINFULTHEP 773. Sinful The P 773 is my only Instagram account. The Sinful The Pimp page is not my account. That is the feds behind that. So if you're following that Sinful The Pimp page, you are following the feds. You are following an enemy of the game. You are following a police caller. Once again, hit them likes, man. Get them likes over 500. But let me just sit up there, you understand me, in my closing. I just want to say to you, you know what I mean, that life is worth living. You got to deposit love into yourself. And you may have to separate. Some of y'all done heard this before, and you already have this. I'm not giving you a revelation, but I want to give you some confirmation of things that you already know. Amen. Some of y'all, in order for you to reach that elevation, it's going to have to be some separation to take place. You got too many toxic people around you. Don't carry them toxic people and them toxic things into 2021. Don't wait until 2021 to change things. Change things today. The time is now. The scripture says redeeming the time for the days are evil. Redeem the time now. Don't wait till tomorrow. You might not have, you know what I mean, next year to even live if you keep these toxic people around you. Anybody that's toxic, anybody that does not benefit you, anybody that does not sit up there and give you any type of encouragement to bring out the greatness in you, if you can't have a conversation with an individual and get any type of uncommon information, you can't get no edification, then why are you having a conversation with this idiot? Let that go. Let that go. You're going to have to make some sacrifices. The price of success is sacrifice. And in order for you to evolve, you're going to have to stop being involved with beautiful trash. Let that beautiful trash go. But seeing he's so handsome, let that trash go. Seeing he don't nobody taste my pussy, you know, like he tastes my pussy. But does he teach you anything? Have you grown? Your credit is now fucked up, right? You back with him and your child living at your mama house, right? Since you done got involved with him, you've been moving backwards, right? Yeah, he don't eat pussy that good. Let that go. Anything that does not bring progression in your life is causing you to have transgression with God and transgression with success. Let that shit go. Let that go. It's some people that I love and still love to this day, but I knew that I had to let them go. Because if I did not let them go, I wouldn't be able to sit up there and manifest the greatness that's within me. I had to let them go. You got too much misery with you. And you done became so demonic, the devil got you so bound, you can't even see this miserable spirit, you know what I mean, that you have right now. Hold on for a minute. Mike, appreciate the Cash App. Good looking. For those of you, my Cash App is in that pen. It's pinned up there. That is my only Cash App. The reason why I say, you know, CNBC saying my only website, my only PayPal, my only Cash App is because individuals have created false PayPals and Cash Apps in my name. The Cash App that you see right there, CN773, that's me, SIN773. That is my cash app. Anything else? That's not me. But I want you to flourish. Even spiritually, God has some things for you individuals. A lot of you individuals that save, you maintaining your salvation. You a righteous individual. But guess what? You will never be able to flourish. You will never be able to experience the fullness of God in his holiness by sitting over there maintaining toxic associations and friendships that's bringing you a battleship with God and success. Let that go. Let go of that. That's trash. And what do with trash? We throw that trash away. We don't keep trash around. Trash has a residue. If you keep trash in your house, that residue will be so strong that it'll start just getting in every room. And no matter how much cologne you spray, no matter how many times you take a shower, if you keep that trash in the house, it'll stink up every damn thing. You done let this trash in the house, now you got bugs and all type of insects coming up in. That trash, it attracts more trash. Did you hear me? Trash attracts trash. Sin, what do you mean? It'll be some trashy ass bitches that'll think that they can fuck with you simply because of the trash that you sitting over there having. Woman, there's some trashy ass motherfucking niggas out there that'll think that they can fuck with you because of that trash ass nigga that you in a relationship with. Let that shit go. Let that shit go, man. Trash attracts trash. You hear niggas saying all the time, man, you know, I know if she fucked with him, you know what I mean? I know she'd let me hit. You know what I mean? If she sat up there and gave him a shot, I know she'd give me a shot. What he's saying is, you know what I mean? She sat up there and fucked with his trash ass. He ain't got shit going on. That nigga's stupid. He ain't got it. So maybe she'll give my dumb ass, maybe she'll give my trash ass an opportunity. Trash attracts trash. Because of you maintaining that trash, you got trash out there that think that they can obtain you because they see you maintaining trash. Trash brings down your value. Let that go. No matter how beautiful a house is, if you have trash inside of it, what does it do? It's bringing down the value. If you go to a house right now, it could be a 6-7 bedroom house. It could be 3 stories. It could have all that. But guess what? If you walk in and it's not embellished, right? The residue, you know what I mean? You can smell the residue of trash. You got newspaper on here. You got dirty diapers and shit all up in this place. You don't give a fuck how big this place is. You like, oh man, I don't want to stay here. Why? Because it's trash in there. Trash attracts trash, and trash hinders class from coming to you. Did you hear what I say? When you maintain in trash, trash will make other trash gravitate to you. But when you're maintaining trash, that which is class, that ain't gonna fuck with you. You holding on to a trashy ass bitch. So that classy woman, she don't want to fuck with you. She said, damn, I seen the status that he made on Facebook. Damn, I seen him working out at the gym. And because I seen him at Whole Foods, because of the way that I seen him taking care of himself, I would think that he would have a woman that's identical to him, a woman that's on one accord with him. But when I seen the trash that he had, I became unattractive. How many ever seen somebody that you was attracted to, but as soon as you seen the individual that they was involved with or the individuals that they was involved with, you weren't even attracted no more. You wasn't even attracted no more. Why? Because they was hanging with trash. Let that trash go. Trash makes other trash gravitate, and trash keep other class from not even wanting to communicate with you. You holding on to a trashy ass bitch. That classy ass woman don't want nothing to do with you because you holding on to trash. You done missed out on the opportunity to have quality. You done missed out on the opportunity to have a blessing because you holding on to that cursing. Let that go. Lay aside every weight that so easily beset you. You got this clean woman, educated woman, dignified woman. You know what I mean? Articulate woman. She want to be involved with you. But once she seen what you was involved with, she said, oh, wow. Well, anybody can have them. A woman don't want no one. A classy, valuable woman, she don't want no man that anybody can have. She want the man that everybody want and can't have. Did you hear what I said? She don't want the man that anybody and everybody can have. The classy, educated, high valued woman, the woman that got her shit in order, she don't want no man that anybody and everybody that's breathing can have. That ain't no prize. That's not an accomplishment. That's nothing valuable. No sacrifices have to be made to obtain it. There's no mental climax that comes with that. That don't make her feel good having something that anybody and everybody can have, but it make a woman feel real good when she got that man that everybody won't and can't have. If you want to be seen like the best definition, did you hear me? If you want to be seen and known as the best definition of important, number one, you have to see yourself like that first. As a man thinketh, so is he. And if you want to be the best definition of important to people, then you got to get rid of, you got to abstain and refrain from being around unimportant people. You got to make sacrifices, you know, you got to sacrifice them unimportant conversations that you be having. Them individuals that be trying to burn up your phone and call you and text you and talk about nothing. They just want to sit up there and talk about the same people that they talked about yesterday and the people last week, and then the same people they did gossip about the other week, and the same people they gossiped about last month and the month before that. They want to call you and give you some new revelations about the same motherfuckers that they've been talking about for months and years. You're wasting God's time talking to fools. That's not why God woke you up today. You have a purpose. You did not wake up because it was just a coincidence. You have a purpose. You have a destiny. You have a ministry. You have capabilities that's beyond measure. But you would never know that hanging around and wasting time with trash. Let that trash go. I love you guys. I hope you hit the like button. I hope the things that I said in this video was meaningful. I hope I said something that was powerful to the point that it'll make you share this, that it'll make you hit the like button so this can get as many likes and recommendations so all the notifications can get out there. I hope it touched you. I love you guys. I will be back because I got other videos that I got to do. As you know, I deleted the Quando Rondo. I might even just do that tomorrow, but I'm still going to come back. If it's 1 o'clock EST time, I'm going to be back probably like an hour and a half from now if God say the same. If I don't, then I'll just come back tomorrow morning. But make sure you get my likes up. Make sure you share this video. It was too much game that was shared in this video for it not to be. It should really have thousands of likes. Don't play with this game. I love you guys. Talk to you. You know what I mean? Another time.